Hello traders, this is Mike Billion. Today is September 6, 2018, and let's talk about the market. So let's start with the spider. The spider, as you can see here, fell below the 5 simple moving average, and you can see here it tests the 20 simple moving average, but it's still bullish and on DMI. It's perfectly trending inside this uptrend channel, and it seems like it failed the Fibonacci resistance to 90. It fell right there, but it's holding at the 20. But overall picture is bullish. It's still bullish, and there was a lot of volume today in this when it went down. So what do you do here? I think what you need to do here is wait until it crossed back about the 5 simple moving average, in this case about 290. If you start trending about 290, then you can start going long again, and the target will be 295. Or if you break down below the 20 simple moving average, which is 286, then this thing is gonna go and test the 280 again. Because now that we don't have this gap right here, it's already closed, there's a high probability that it goes up. I would say 60% probability goes up, 30% probability moves sideways from here, and there is a small probability that they're going and test the bottom of the channel or the Fibonacci 280. Overall, the spider is still bullish. Now let's see the IWN, the iShares Russell. Perfectly bullish, as you can see here, it's still trending. It failed at 173 Fibonacci extension, and you can see here it's also the 20 simple moving average. So 170 is support because it was resistant back in June and July, and now is support. It was resisting, now support. So this is an important level you need to watch, 170. If it cross below 170 and stay there, then the major support will be 166. DMI is bullish and strong, so you gotta be careful right here. ADX is below 20, so we might trend below, you know, we trend sideways right here, waiting for October reports. So let's see what happens. Overall, the IWM is bullish. The other one that I wanted to talk about is the DIA, which is the Dow Jones ATF. And you can see here, it hasn't made higher highs like it did in the IWM and the spider, but it's still trending. It's now right here, holding the 5 simple moving average. This one looks more bullish, but I just think that it's gonna just move sideways right here until it probably slowly go to 263. Overall, it's bullish, but I don't like the setup right here. I'll prefer to wait to see what happens. The other ones that I wanted to talk about is Apple. You can see Apple went up really nicely. It fell at 225, but it's still there. There was a huge divergence on directionals. The minus directional was the bottom, the plus direction was up top, and ADX is really high, meaning we might get a pause right here until the next report. I don't think we're gonna go down. I think it's just gonna move sideways right here between 225 and 214, and it's gonna wait for the report. So I don't see anything to trade right there. BABA, I see a great opportunity right here now that it break down the 163. ADX is bearish. I think if it confirms tomorrow below 158, I think this thing is going to start trending to 143. There's some support there, but the major support is a 112. Overall, BABA looks terrible, looks bearish. So be careful with BABA. Right now, the other one that I wanted to talk about is Tesla. So you can compare this chart with any of the charts that I just showed you, and this one is all over the place. So you really have to be careful when you're trading Tesla, because you can see this chart is all over the place. It has a huge spike, huge breakdowns, it moves all over the place. If you talk about technicals, it looks like it break down this short-term support, and it's trending down. The major support that I see after that is 235. And you can see this, their resistance is at 382. I wouldn't touch this one. I think it's very, very dangerous, especially if you trade options, because any tweet, any rumor, any whatever, it will spike, will break down with anything. But I like to watch it because it's a nice stop. You can make a lot of money with this one, but also you can lose a lot of money. But overall, I don't see any setup right here. If you want to enter short right here, if it cross about 284, you have to jump out. That will be your stop loss. But as I said, this one can just trend down for 1 or 2 days and then spike in only one day go to 320. So let's see what happens. I wanted to talk about Twitter also. Twitter is doing really bad. Let me show you Twitter. Twitter break down this major trend support. Major trend support with the last 2 days has been huge volume. So if you trend below today's low, which is 3250, no, 3250. The low was 3251. Right now it's at 3080. Oh, it's doing really bad. So I think if you trend down around below 30, this thing can go easily to $22. There's some support at 30 that you can see here. There's a may it's gonna be a major bottle right here with the bulls at 30. This Fibonacci right here, it was support back in April. It was support and resisting in the beginning of the year. So the bulls are gonna fight there. DMI is extremely bearish. And I think if it trend down below 30 in the 20s, in the high 20s, this thing is gonna break down really hard to $22 because you can see here there is no support here. There's no support below 30. The other one that I wanted to show you is MU Microtechnology. It's also trending down, and you can see here it's very near to major support, which is $42. It's a major support right here, and there is a trend support right there at this support. So it's very near there. It's a 44 now, but if it goes there, it might be a good trade to go long from there. It's gonna report in September 20, so let's see what happens. But if it break down this support, then it's gonna go to 35. Okay, traders, this is everything for today. Trade on.